Linux Mint team did it again. Although Linux Mint version 19.1 is a marginal upgrade, it brings many new features which are worth upgrading. Let's have a look at Linux Mint 19.1. Panel layout. There is a new panel layout. The new panel now has icons only style in the taskbar. If you open several instances of the same app, they will be grouped together. As I showed in one of my previous videos, this panel could be easily enabled before with Icing Task Manager extension. I also said I wished this taskbar was the default in Linux Mint. Now it is. This is really great. You can also go to the settings of this panel and adjust it to your liking. You can also switch back to the older, more traditional panel. Many thanks to the Linux team for this great work. I believe many Linux Mint users will like this new panel. Welcome screen. The Linux Mint team keeps improving the Linux Mint welcome screen. The welcome screen has a new look with Xapp sidebar and a head bar. The first steps will help you to configure your system and start working as fast as possible. Now, firewall is listed among the first steps. You can also choose here the panel layout. File manager Nemo. Nemo is now 3 times faster than before. Its code was reviewed and optimized. It feels extremely light and browsing directories is a breeze. These changes are immediately noticeable. Thumbnails can be configured depending on the directory you are browsing. Also, Nemo now uses an Xapp preference window. Nemo is now able to show file creation times, but only on X64 file system without home directory encryption. Update Manager. The Update Manager is able to list mainline kernels and to show their support status. There is also a new button to remove unused kernels. Very nice additions. Software Sources. The Software Sources tool was given a new look. Similar to the welcome screen, it is now using an Xapp sidebar and a head bar. Previously, to simplify the process of bug reports, users had to install debug symbols. Now, support for debug symbols can be enabled with a click of a mouse. You can also now remove duplicate entries in your repositories in the Maintenance tab. Input methods. The language settings and the input methods are now separated into 2 separate applications. The input method tool uses an icon sidebar and now shows a dedicated page for each supported language. Clear instructions are provided for each language, to guide you through not only installing support packages, but also selecting the right input method. Xapp improvements. Improvements were made to the look and feel of Xapps. Thumbnails and page borders are more crisp now in XReader. XAdd status bar now indicates whether the document is in tab or space mode, and highlight modes are searchable. Xapps also have better preference windows now. Sudo. This is a really great change. Linux Mint keeps getting more and more user-friendly. Now, sudo shows asterisks when you type your password. This is where many new users got lost, because previously nothing appeared when you typed your password. Now, you can see that your password is typed. This also prevents users from typing a password into a wrong window and sending it online by mistake. Artwork improvements. There are many new wallpapers. The Mint White theme are now available in more colors and have more contrast. Icons now have better support for both light and dark panels. Other improvements. There are some improvements on Nvidia card performance. Input lag was reduced, the window manager feels more responsive when moving windows, Cinnamon 4 uses less RAM, and some of the long-standing rendering issues are fixed now. Linux Mint 19.1 features Linux kernel 4.15 and an Ubuntu 18.4 package base. Linux Mint 19 will receive security update until 2023. If you want to upgrade to Linux Mint 19.1, subscribe and hit the bell notification. I will show the upgrade process in the next video. There is really nothing to say about Linux Mint 19.1. It brings many new features and it just works. What is your experience with Linux Mint 19.1? Let me know in the comment section below, and thank you for watching.